Welcome students. So we'll continue with the reported speech. Today we'll study different kinds of sentences. How we change statements, how do we change WH questions, yes or no questions, commands, request, exclamatory and all that. Then next class we'll go for paragraphs, that is dialogues. Then we'll have exam questions so that you are perfectly thorough. The first two classes we had studied about the rules and a little bit of revisions on that. So, see page number 28. There they have given different kinds of sentences. And let us see, what are they? The first one is, kids said. Before going to that, let me tell you, when the direct speech contains a universal truth, a habitual action, historical event, or a scientific fact, the present tense of the direct speech is not changed. It is given after the sentences in between, you see. If the reported speech expresses a universal truth, habitual action, historical, geographical, or scientific fact, the tense of the verb in the indirect speech remains the same. Also, when the reporting verb is either in the present or the future, then also there is no change in the tense of the verb in the indirect speech. So, on this basis, we will do some sentences. The sentences given on the top are based on these. So, first one is, Keats said. You know Keats? John Keats, one of the famous poets. So, he said, truth is beauty. Truth is beauty. In bracket, DS means direct speech. RS means reported speech. So, truth is beauty. So, this is a universal truth. Truth is always beauty. Nobody will tell the truth is not beauty. So, truth is beauty. It's a universal truth. In this case, the verb, that is, remains is only. Present tense will remain as present tense only. Though the reporting verb is in the past tense. Keats said. Said is a reporting verb. So, how it is changed? Keats said that truth is beauty. In normal circumstances, we say that truth was beauty. But here, because it contains a universal truth, we say Keats said that truth is beauty. The second sentence, Viba, this is in the quote form, I study for 2 hours every day. I study for 2 hours every day. This is a habitual action. Habitual means it's a regular habit. So this also remains in the present tense only. Viba said that she studies. Studies and study is both are present tense only. Just because first person we say study I. Here because it is she, we say studies. Both are the same tenses. For 2 hours every day. So here because it is a habitual action, the tense remains the same. Viba said that she studies for 2 hours every day. I hope you are following the text. See the screen or have the textbook in your hand. Third one, and underline some things. For example, first one you write at the end, there's a place. You write there. It is a universal truth. Second sentence, Viba, that is, you write in bracket ali, a habitual action. Third one, Sagar said, the earth revolves around the sun. Here also, it contains a universal truth. The earth revolves around the sun. So, we should not change the tense here. So, reported speech is, Sagar said that the earth revolves around the sun. Same tense. Present tense remains, present tense only. Again, at the end, please mention, it is a universal truth. Sagar said that the earth revolves around the sun. You must underline the verbs also. And direct speech verb, reported speech verb. And you will understand much better. Next one is, Rubina says, I am doing my homework. Here, It is neither a universal truth or habitual action. But here, the reporting verb says is in the present tense. I told you there is another rule. When the reporting verb in the present or the future tense, then also we do not change the tense of the direct speech. So here also, the tense will remain as it is. So reported speech will be, Rubina says that she is doing her homework. She is doing her homework. See, I am doing, present continuous, is doing, present continuous. Only that, because the subject is changing, I becomes she. So it becomes is doing. So in this sentence also, because the reporting verb is in the present tense, the tense of the direct speech remains the same. Please write at the end in bracket, reporting verb, present tense, so that you will understand. Next is, Praveen will complain. The rules are not followed. Here, the reporting verb is will complain. And as you know, will complain is future tense. So here also, the direct speech verb, that is R, will remain R only. So see the reported speech. Praveen will complain that the rules are not followed. It remains the same. So I hope you understood. There are five sentences here. The first one is universal truth. Second one is habitual action. Third one is universal truth. Fourth one is reporting verb, present tense. Fifth one is reporting verb, future tense. In all these cases, the verb in the reported speech is not changed. It remains as it was in direct speech. The same thing is explained here. If the reported speech expresses a universal truth, habitual action, historical event, geographical fact, or a scientific fact, the tense of the verb in the indirect speech remains the same. Also, when the reporting verb is either the present or the future tense, there is no change in the tense of the verb in the indirect speech. It's very important. So next, we have got some dialogues. This I'll do in the next class, because all the dialogues I'll do together. Here we'll do only sentences today, so that you understand properly. All the dialogues and exercise completions we'll do in the next class. Okay. Now, let me go to some sentences. Rohit said, if you are interested, you can take them down. Rohit said, inverted commas open, I practice the piano daily. Rohit said, inverted commas, I practice the piano daily. What kind of sentence? It is a habit. It is a regular action, habitual action. So here also tense will not change. Okay. Reported speech only. Rohit said that he practices the piano daily. He practices. It's also present tense only. Because it is he, we are going for S form. So I hope you have taken down. Rohit said, I practice the piano daily. Practice. S form. P-R-A-C-T-I-S-E, verb. In reported speech, Rohit said that he practices the piano daily. Next sentence. The teacher says, I teach grammar. I'm giving you simple sentences. The teacher says. Here, the reporting verb is says. It is in present tense. So, we should not change the tense of the direct in the indirect speech. Okay. The teacher says that she teaches grammar. So teaches, again, present tense only. The teacher says, I teach grammar. The teacher says that she teaches grammar. Write down in the bracket, reporting verb is in the present tense. Third sentence, the man said, the sun rises in the east. What kind of sentence? It's a universal truth. The man said, the sun rises in the east. Again, we will not change the tense here. Okay. The man said that the sun rises in the east. The man said that the sun rises in the east. Right in bracket, universal truth. Next one. Rakesh says, I go for jogging daily. Rakesh says, I go for jogging daily. Here, in the reporting verb is in the present tense again. Says. So, no change of tense in the reported speech. So, Rakesh says that he goes for jogging daily. I go, he goes. Both are same tense. So, here also, please write down in bracket, reporting verb, present tense. So, there is no change in the reported speech. Next one. The teacher said, Akbar is a great king. You put it in not commas. Akbar is a great king. So, here, it is a historical fact. So, here again, we will not change the tense. The teacher said that Akbar is a great king. The teacher said that Akbar is a great king. Now, I want to do all the sentences, like for example, statements, some examples, WH questions, few examples, yes or no questions, commands, requests, and exclamatory, so that you are thorough. Then only you will be able to do. What happens, you know, in exam, it will be a mixture. It will be a combination of a statement, WH question, yes or no questions, exclamatory, it may be anything. All, if you know the rules and how to change them, you will be finding it very easy. Otherwise, reported speech will be, it's a very difficult task. Okay, we'll go slowly, but please understand. And as far as possible, take down some notes. Now, a few statements. The first one, Sujata said, I have been to Canada. You know to comma sali. I have been to Canada. So here, verb is have been. Yen tense adu? Present perfect tense. Yen agbeku adu? Past perfect tense. Okay. This you must remember, then go. Sujata said that she had been to Canada. So have been becomes had been. Okay. Second one. The stranger said, I came from Mumbai. The stranger said, I came from Mumbai. So, here, came is simple past tense. And simple past tense becomes past perfect tense. Okay. So, the stranger said that he had come from Mumbai. The stranger said that he had come from Mumbai. Okay, third one, Srinath said, I shall do business. I shall do business. Verb is shall do. In tense, simple future tense. Simple future tense. Okay, here you have to change the model. Shall has to be changed into past tense. Okay, so Srinath said that he would do business. As I told you, shall can become should or would. And in most cases, it becomes would only. Why? Because the subject is changing. I becomes he here. And basic grammar, I told you, shall is used for first person and will is used for second and third person. So, in the reported speech, we have third person. So, we should go for the past tense of will. Though the direct speech contains shall, we should not write should. Should go for would only. Okay. So, Srinath said that he would do business. He would do business. Now, you should not write he should. Should. Okay. Some cases it becomes should when it is an obligation. Not a question of tense. That I will tell you when the sentence comes. Next one. Children said, we like ice cream. So, what is the tense here? Like. Simple present. It becomes simple past. Okay. Children said that they liked ice cream. They liked ice cream. Okay. Next is Suresh said, I don't know Hindi. I don't know Hindi. It is a simple present tense but negative sentence. I know, I don't know. So it is changed like this. Suresh said that he did not know Hindi. Suresh said that he did not know Hindi. Don't know becomes did not know. Okay. So, these are the statements, assertive sentences. So, I hope you have understood. In assertive sentence, put that, combine the two parts by that, then change the pronoun and put it as a subject, change the tense and put it as the verb. And if there is any other word, you have to change accordingly. Okay. Next, I'll do a few WH questions. I told you WH questions means questions starting with WH words. Who, what, when, where, why, and all that. Okay. We'll do at least three. Mother said to Johnny, what are you doing? You know, commas, huh? What are you doing? This is a WH question. So, in WH question, how do you change? Insert, introduce an interrogative verb like asked, questioned, inquired, then followed by WH word only, then subject, then verb. Subject means pronoun change, verb means tense change. If you follow the rules, you will not make a mistake at all. Okay, in no case you must put that here. Only in statements that is put in between. Here you have directly you put a WH word only. Okay, the reported speech will be, mother asked Johnny, said has become asked, interrogative verb though. Then straight away WH word, what he was doing. He is the subject. So you became he here, are doing becomes was doing. So this is how you change. Mother asked Johnny what he was doing. Next one. The policeman said to the man, where is your license? Again, WH question. The policeman asked the man where his license was. Straight away, WH word, where, then subject, his license, then verb, was. Third one. The father said to his son, how did you write the exam? The father said to the son, how did you write the exam? Again, WH question. So the father asked his son, how he had written the exam. So directly, how you have to put, then subject is he, verb. There it is did write. Here, that is mean did write is equal to wrote. It is past tense only. Did write is nothing but past tense. Simple past. So, it becomes past perfect tense. He had written the exam. Now, you realize how important the tenses are. You must know. Because it is a question, it is put did. And the verb is present tense only. But when both are combined, it is past tense only. Okay. Then, yes or no questions. One or two. The teacher said to Arun, do you play tennis? Do you play tennis? It is an yes or no question. Either it becomes yes or no. The reported speech is, the teacher asked Arun, interrogative verb, asked Arun whether he played tennis. So you have to introduce interrogative verb, then followed by whether or if, followed by subject and verb. Okay. The teacher asked Arun whether he played tennis. One more. Mohan said to Madhu, have you completed the project? Mohan said to Madhu, have you completed the project? So, again, yes or no question. Mohan asked Madhu if, whether or if, he had completed the project. He had completed the project. So, you becomes he here, have completed, becomes had completed the project. You must be knowing when you form a question, the verb is split. Subject goes in between. Do you know the answer? For example, you is the subject and verb is do plus know. But when it is a statement, subject comes first and the verbs join together. I have taken. Have you taken becomes I have taken. So same pattern. Then, next, commands. One or two commands I'll give. The general said to the soldiers, shoot the enemy. What is the rule for a command? Introduce verbs of command. Ordered, commanded, followed by infinitive form of the verb. Infinitive verb. To do, to go, to play is infinitive. So, here, the general ordered the soldiers to shoot the enemy. The general said becomes ordered the soldier to shoot the enemy. Next is one more. The inspector said to the criminal, show me your pass. The inspector said to the criminal, show me your pass. Order it. The inspector ordered the criminal to show him his pass. The inspector ordered the criminal, infinitive form, to show is infinitive, him, his pass. Generally, we don't put order to the criminal. It becomes a bad English. Order the criminal. So, this is about commands. Send request one or two. Suma said to Sudha, kindly do it for me. It's a request. Suma said to Sudha, kindly do it for me. Here, Suma requested Sudha to do it for her. So, verb becomes requesting. There it is said, it becomes requested. Again, infinity form. Suma requested Sudha to do it for her. One more. Arjun said to his friend, please give me some money. It's also a request. Arjun said to his friend, please give me some money. Here, Arjun requested his friend to give him some money. Arjun requested his friend to give him some money. Then, one or two exclamations, exclamatory sentences. Exclamatory sentences are changed just like a statement. There will be that, there will be subject, there will be verb. What will be the difference? The verb will be exclamatory verb. Said barala, exclaimed, exclaimed joyfully, exclaimed sorrowfully, whatever may be. Okay, first one. Suchitra said, how hot it is. And put an exclamation mark. Acharya symbol. Suchitra said, how hot it is. Here, Suchitra exclaimed. Said barala, exclaimed. That. Just like a statement, put that. It was very hot. Subject verb. It was very hot. Okay. Suchitra exclaimed that it was very hot. Next one. The man said, alas. Put an exclamation mark. My dog is dead. Okay. Alas. My dog is dead. Exclamation mark. So here is sorrow. Okay. The man exclaimed sorrowfully. Because exclamation can be sorrow, joy, maybe anything. The man exclaimed sorrowfully that his dog was dead. That his dog was dead. Now, a few extra sentences. We'll see. The owner said, it is miscellaneous. The owner said, I built the house last year. The owner said that. Built is past tense. So, he becomes past perfect tense. He had built the house previous year. So, last year becomes, last becomes previous. Okay. The owner said that he had built the house the previous year. One more. The boy said, I shall do my PhD. I shall do my PhD. Shall do. Simple future. So, the boy said that he would do his PhD. He would do. Why shall becomes would? Because I has become he. Okay. The boy said that he would do his PhD. Next one. Gonzalo said to Jonito, root them out. R-O-U-T-E. Root them out. He tell the priest to go away. So, this is a command. So, answer will be, reported speech will be, Gonzalo ordered Jonito to root them out. Gonzalo ordered Juanito to root them out. Next, Laura said to Petra, give me the breadcrumbs. It's again imperative only. Give me the breadcrumbs. But it's a mild order. So we can say, Laura asked Petra. Laura asked Petra to give her the breadcrumbs. Infinitive form. To give her the breadcrumbs. Then the teacher said, Nile is the longest river in the world. Nile. This is a universal truth. So we should not change the tense again. The teacher said that Nile is the longest river. Not was the longest. Is the longest river because it is a universal truth. The principal said to the students, come tomorrow. Here you see, command only. So the principal asked the students to come the next day. To come the next day. Here, since it is a mild, it's an instruction, you do not say ordered. You can say asked also. The principal asked the students to come the next day. Next one. The father said to his son, do not see the mobile. The father asked his son not to see the mobile. Here, since it's a negative sentence, you have to put not. The father asked his son not to see the mobile. So next is one more sentence, a few more sentences. The officer said to the visitor, where do you come from? WH question, where do you come from? The officer asked the visitor where he came from. Where do you come is present tense. Where he came from. Next one. The woman said, I read the Quran daily. The woman said, I read the Quran daily. This is a habitual action, regular habit. So don't change the tense. The woman said that she reads the Quran daily. The woman said that she reads the Quran daily. Next, Mary said, I forgot to bring my umbrella. I forgot to bring my umbrella. So Mary said that, simple statement, Mary said that she had forgotten. See, forgot is simple past. Had forgotten is past perfect. Had forgotten to bring her umbrella. To bring her umbrella. Next one. The king said to the criminal, you can go anywhere now. You can go anywhere now. The king said to the criminal that he could go anywhere then. He could go. Can go in becomes could go. Amele now becomes then. So the king said to the criminal that he could go anywhere then. Next one. Laura said to Gonzalo, you have disturbed the birds. You have disturbed the birds. So Laura said to Gonzalo that he had disturbed the birds. He had disturbed the birds. Next, Laura said to Gonzalo, do you use your handkerchief as a shoe brush? Commonly asked in the exam. Last year also it came. So, do you use your handkerchief as a shoe brush? Yes or no question idu. Laura asked Gonzalo if he used, there it is used, here it is used, his handkerchief as a shoe brush. His handkerchief as a shoe brush. Again, I'll say, Laura asked Gonzalo if he used his handkerchief as a shoe brush. Next one. Laura said to Gonzalo, Do you sneeze? This is an yes or no question. Do you sneeze? So, Laura asked Gonzalo if he sneezed. See, it is sneeze, simple present tense. It becomes sneezed. Laura asked Gonzalo if he sneezed. Last one. Gonzalo, have the priests gone, Jonito? Gonzalo is asking Jonito, have the priests gone, Jonito? So it will be changed like this. Gonzalo asked Jonito whether the priests had gone. There it is, have gone. It becomes had gone. Present perfect tense becomes past perfect tense. Gonzalo asked Jonito whether the priests had gone. So, we have done a sufficient number of examples. I have done all types of sentences, statements, WH questions, yes or no questions, commands, requests, exclamatory sentences, negative forms of sentences. So, all we have dealt with so that you are able to do all kinds of sentences. And exams only, they just combine them. They have one statement, one WH question, one yes or no questions, and something may be a command. So, 5 sentences will be together and 5 marks will be there. So, if you know these things, you can easily do that. There's no much problem. And generally, a few lessons are designed for exam orientation. So, generally, sunny morning is taken. Most of the years, sunny morning, there are some areas. When we have direct classes, I will mark them. Let us hope for the best. When you come, we will see. I will mark. And as I told you, this exam, I was asked to give a revision for the students. I just did this same on video. Only one example I did. That is about the same. Do you use a handkerchief and all that. And it came last year also. I did not expect this year, but that only has come. So what happens, you know, since I have got a lot of experience in all these teaching line, I'll be able to judge and tell you. When we come directly, we will discuss and I'll tell you which are the areas where the reported speech questions are set. I hope you have understood all the types of sentences. Because straight away what happens, you know, if I go for paragraphs, dialogues, you may not probably understand. If you know these things, first what happened, I have given the rules, how to change. I have given how the tenses are changed, how pronouns are changed, how WH questions are changed, how yes or no question is changed, how commands are changed, how request is changed, how exclamatory sentences are changed. When all these things you know, there's nothing, no difficulty in putting them together. And next class, that is next video, we will take, starting with this example, see the page number, same 28 where we are teaching. One is, what are you doing this weekend? And before this also we have one more dialogue, I'll show you that. I think it is here. That is page number 25. American Swami Tirtha, American Swami Tirtha and all that. From here I'll start. That means this is a dialogue form. Okay, dialogue form. And one by one, if you start doing, you will be able to do in the exam well. Different, for example, see, first question is, where is your luggage? That is a WH question. Sentence, statement, my whole luggage, where is? All these things are mixed up. So, if you do this, and then one more class I'll take, where we will have only exam questions. When we have exam questions, you will be thorough. And definitely one of that only will come in the exam. If you take interest and if you follow my guidelines, you will definitely score the highest marks. I want somebody from our college to score centum. They score in science subjects, commerce subjects, 100 out of 100. Why not in English? Nothing is impossible. I see this year the highest was 94. Of course, I came only for 2 months at the end, two and a half months I was teaching. But this year, then coming next exam, I want you to score the highest marks, that is 100 out of 100, it is not that easy, but it is possible. Okay, what happens, you know, there is a thing, English is very easy to pass, but very difficult to score. If you keep this in mind, you have to be very, very careful. And all the tests, this Google Forms are just IVR because we don't have other alternative. We have to create some questions and give. That is to see that you have understood the lesson or not. But weekly tests, I am giving in such a way that it is exam oriented only. 4 more questions, if you see, they are all exam questions. 6 more questions also, exam questions. I have seen last month's weekly test only, the first test people have done. Second test, very few people have done. And some people have just, I don't know, they have circulated, the same copy is being put here and there. We can easily find out. Don't think that if we can't find out. One man is preparing the answer, 4 people are sending it. So, don't do that. Since you are doing at home, you can refer the book. There's nothing wrong. But do it your own. And then send it properly. Some of the answers we can't read. You don't even capture the photo properly. Okay. So, be a little careful and write the answers according to the my instruction. That is the limit. Short answers, very short. Okay. Long answers, 80 to 100 words. One paragraph. 6 more questions, 200 words. You must follow. Google Forms are, I tell you, only to see that whether you have understood or not. Okay. Answering a Google Form doesn't mean that you know everything. That is okay. Even that is good. But the weekly test, please take some interest and do it. I want some improvement. And when we come to the college, I want to see how far you are able to do this reported speech. Okay, then. Thank you.